प्रपन्न पारिजाताय स्तोत्रवीत्रैकपाणये ज्ञानमुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः।
ओम प्रपन्न पारिजाताय स्तोत्रवेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञानमुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः। We are studying Srimad Bhagavad Gita with Shankar's commentary and on Tuesday we read up to Shloka 28 of the 13th chapter, but we could not complete the commentary on Shloka 28. So the context is that up to Shloka 26 the Kshetra Kshetrajna Gyan has been told in all its details and ramifications. And what is left is separately telling about the what is knowledge and what is its effect. So for that 27 and 28 were taken. In the 27 it was said, Samam Sarveshu Bhuteshu Tishtantam Parameshwaram Vinashad Su avinashyantam yapashyati sapashyanti. Parameshwaram sarveshu bhuteshu samam tishtan tishtantam vinashyatsu avinashyantam yapashyati sapashyati. So seeing Paramatman, Parameshwar, in all the beings, in same way or in equal measure, equally staying in all the beings. The beings vary in their body and mind. From Brahma up to blade of grass, all are beings. But Parameshwar is not different in them. He stays same way in all of them. And they are all Nashavan. They are all subject to destruction. Brahma to blade of grass. But he stays in them without being destructible. Like this, one who sees, he really sees. That means the Samajnan has been described. Like this who sees, he sees that beings are different and destructible, but in all of them, Paramatma, Parameshwar is the same, indestructible. That is the right vision. And so, the person who does not see like that are ignorant, they have nishance, they have ajnana, they have wrong knowledge. And then, in 28 we are told, Samam Pashyan Hi Sarvatra Samavasthitam Ishwaram Nainasti Atmana Atmanam Tato Yati Paramgati. So the vision of the last shloka is repeated. Ishwaram sarvatra samavastitam samam pashyan. He means because. In the last shloka it was told, he who sees like this only sees. Others are ignorant. Why? That hetu is given here. Because Ishwara, Parameshwar is same as Ishwara, sarvatra, everywhere, every being, everywhere. Samyak avasthitam, rightly staying samam, equally. Equally staying, rightly staying in all, everywhere. He, because such a man does not kill himself by himself, So he goes to the final goal. So the question had arisen that can anybody kill himself? So what is the speciality in telling that such man can does not kill himself? Except for the so-called suicide, nobody has seen anybody killing himself. And as far as self is concerned, nobody can kill also. So what is the special implication of this shloka? This question arises. So we read the commentary. Yathoktasya samyak darshanasya phalavachanena stuti kartavya iti shloka arabhyate. So that right knowledge which has been told, its result must be told. And by telling the result, its efficacy in life should be described. That is being told here. Samam pashyan upalabhamano. Pashyan means seeing. Seeing means directly experiencing. So pashyan is called as upalabhamano. Sarvatra means sarvabhutesh. Everywhere means in all beings, as described in the previous shloka. Samavastitam, tulyataya avastitam, Ishwaram. So, samavastitam, I said, rightly staying, that is correct. But Shankaracharya says, tulyataya avastitam, in the same measure. Tulyataya, that means you can put a balance, same weight everywhere. So, tulyataya avastitam, Ishwaram. Atita anantara shlokokta lakshanam ittartha. Atita anantara means past, immediate past. That means previous shloka. So, about this staying same in all has been described in the previous shloka. In that way, it is repeated here. Samam pashyan, what happens if we see like that? Kim na hinasti, hinsam na karoti, atmana svena eva swam atmanam. He does not kill himself by himself. Tad ahinsanat, and because of that non-killing, yati param prakrushtam gatim mokshakhyam. Param gati means moksha. So he reaches moksha. And then the doubt in the mind. Remember, this is not Arjuna's doubt. Huh? Arjuna has understood. This nanu khalu are our doubts. Because we do not understand what Bhagavan is telling Arjuna, common math. So his doubts. Nanu na eva kashchit prani Swayam swamatmanam hinasti katham uchyate apraptam na hinasti iti. We feel that no being kills himself by himself. Then when it is not possible itself, apraptam na hinasti iti katham uchyate. So it is said it does not kill. When it is not possible at all to kill, we do not see anybody killing himself. Then what is the meaning in telling that he does not kill? Yathana prithivyam agni cheta vyona antariksha ityadi. So somebody says you should not burn fire on earth. Somebody says you should not burn fire in intermediate space. So if he says you do not burn fire in earth, where shall we burn? It has to be burned. So this is a wrong statement to say fire cannot be burnt on the earth. And intermediate space, nobody can burn the air. So to say that you should not burn fire also is meaningless. So both are meaningless. This because it is always real. It can never be contradicted. And that is never real. Always contradicted. So in both cases, the statement is meaningless. Similarly, to say that a man cannot kill himself is meaningless. Na esha dosha. Shankaracharya said this statement is not wrong. There are two ways in which men can kill themselves. Men are killing themselves. The ignorant men are killing themselves in not one but two ways. Ajnanam atma tiraskaranopapattehe. That is the general statement in one sentence. The ignorant people, they do not recognize their, you may say, tiraskar. What could be the English of tiraskar? That means non-acceptance. Ignoring the self. Ignoring is a little mild. Tiraskar means non-accepting. Tiraskar normally is used in language for hatred. So, here hatred in the sense non-acceptance. The ignorant man is reasonable, upapatteye, atma tiraskarana upapatteye. Upapatti means rational. It is reasonable that the ignorant man does not accept Atman. So that is killing. Now in two ways he will show. Sarvohi adnya atyanta prasiddham sakshat aparokshat atmanam tiraskritya anatmanam atmatvena parigruhya. So, all the ignorant people, that Atman which is direct and directly experienced, Atmanam, not accepting that, they take another non-self to be self. What they think is self is not the self. The real self is directly perceptible in a much more direct way, sakshat aparokshat, and even then they do not accept it and accept some non-self as self. And about that self which they accept as self, tam api dharma dharmo kritva upattam atmanam hatva. So doing punya or pap, that what is they are taking as Atman? So by doing punya or pap, they get another body. Upattam means get, earn. Atma tam api dharma dharma krutva upattam atmanam hatva. So that body they kill because the punya pap will generate next birth. So this body is killed, which they are taking as Atman. So they are killing Atman. Anyam Atmanam upadatte navam, and they get another Atman, another body, new. Tamcha evam hatva anyam, evam in this very way. They kill that also. Tamcha eva mahatva anyam. That also they kill like this. Evam tamapi hatva anyam iti evam. And that they go on killing. That again they kill. The body which they are taking as Atman is killed in every life. So they are going on killing their Atman. Iti Atmaha Sarvaha Agga. So all ignorant people are Atma killers. They are killers of themselves. Because they do not accept the real self as self. They take body-mind complex to be their self. And that self, by doing punya and pap, has to take new work. So this body they kill and take new body. And that they kill and take new body, and that they kill and new body. So they go on killing themselves. All ignorant people. First way of killing themselves. Second, yatu paramarthatma aso api sarvada avidya hata iva vidyamana phala bhava iti sarve atmana eva avidvansa. And that which is real atman. This is assumed Atman, they are killing everybody. But the real Atman, by their ignorance, is always killed. Because they do not accept it. So they do not accept the real Atman in the first meaning. They do not accept the real Atman and accept something else as Atman. And that something else is killed every life. Second meaning is that non-acceptance of the real Atman itself is killing it. Vidyamana phalabhava. How do you say they kill it? If Atman would have been present, that means if Atman is accepted or Atman is present in everybody. And then the man of knowledge, he gets the right result. If he accepts, asserts real Atman, then he gets the desired result, that is moksha. In contrast, because they do not accept, so they are as if killing. Yatu itaro yatokta atma darshi, the other one, the man of knowledge, who sees right. So, uvayata api atmana atmanam nahi nasti. In none of the two ways he kills himself. He does not take body to be self. So, no question of killing that body and getting, he does not get another body, has been told. So, there is no question of killing the body again and again. And he accepts the real Atman. So, in that way also he is not killing. He is getting the result of that Atman being there, the moksha. So that is the meaning. Nainasti tato yati param gatim yathoktam phalam labati tasya labati. So the fruit result of already told is moksha, and that they are getting. Now, this real knowledge and its result will be told in several languages, several ways, same thing. So, what happens to this man? Real man with real knowledge. What does he see? Prakrutyaivacha karmani kriyamanani sarvasha yap pasyati tathātmānam akartāram sapashyati. Tatha, he sees two things. He sees that all karmas are being done by prakriti. Indriyas acting on objects. Indriyas also a form of prakriti. Objects also a form of prakriti. So he sees that prakriti is working. And Atman is seen as a non-doer. they see the Atman is not involved at all in any karma being done. Everything is being done, every changes are occurring in Prakriti. The Atma is non-doer. So these two things they see, so there is the right vision. Yapashyati, sapashyati. So Atma Jnana has been told in another way. We are told samam pashyan, sapashyati. Here we are told Prakriti is working, Atman is not working. So this is another aspect of the same knowledge. One who sees that God is same in all, he is seeing this also. The Prakriti is working, Atma is not working. And so his seeing, his experience is correct. Sarvabhutastham isham samam pashyan na hinasti atmana atmanam iti uktam tad anupapannam saguna karma vailakshanya bheda bhinneshu atmasu iti etad ashankya. This is Arjuna's doubt that if beings are separate, then how do you say that they are seeing the same in all? For that, this reply. Okay, suppose separate. But their vision is that Prakriti is working. I am not working. So, result becomes the same. Atmasu. Swaguna karma vailakshanya veda vinneshu atmasu. They feel Atmans are different because their guna, karma are different characteristics. Vailakshanya, actually not different, separate. But the characteristics of guna and karma are different with each Atman, with each individuality. So such doubt may come in Arjuna's mind, so Bhagavan is replying. Or Arjuna may not get that. We all are still getting that. So the reply is to make the knowledge universal. Prakriti Bhagavato Maya Trigunatmika. So Prakriti means Maya. Trigunatmika Maya. Bhagavan himself has said, my Prakriti. Mayam tu Prakriti Vidya. Remember, wherever the word Maya comes, Shankar quotes Shata Shatru, nothing else. Maya is dealt with, Swami Vivekananda said in his Jnana Yoga. Maya in Vedic literature is correctly depicted only in Shata Shatru, and among commentators only by Shankaracharya. This is what Swamiji has said. Because Buddhists and others interpret in their own way. Not correct. And in Vedas, the picture was never clear till it is told in Shatashatara. And Shatashatara has one line. Mayam tu Prakritim Vidyat, Mayinam tu Maheshwaram. Maya, no Prakriti to be Maya. And the Lord of Maya is Bhagavan. This much Shatashatara has made everything clear. Iti Mantra Varnat. Mantra Varnat means Sangita portion Upanishad. Mantra Varnat means Sangita portion. Taya prakritya eva cha. So that prakriti, which is Bhagavan's Maya, Trigunatmika. Taya prakritya eva. By that prakriti only. Na anneno. not by anybody else. Now, Mahadadi Karya Karana Kara Parinataya. How does Prakriti work? Prakriti has transformed itself in Mahat and so on and so forth till body and Indriyas. Starting from Mahat up to body and Indriyas, it is transformation of Prakriti. And that transformed Prakriti works. Works are done by body and Indriyas, we see that. So body and Indriyas are the final transformed roop of Prakriti. That very Prakriti which is Bhagavan's Maya Trigunatmika. And it is this transformed Prakriti only. Karmani. What is work? Vang manakaya arambakani kriyamanani. So to exhaust karma, all karmas, he means karma done by vani, by mind, by body. So kaya manavakya, everywhere we say like that. Totality of karma is by speech, mind and body. Arambakani, they do that karma. Kriyamanani, that means they start and do. Arambakani kriyamanani. Nirvartyamanani, another meaning. Start, do, complete. That means all karmas start with vani mana kaya and are being done there and end there. All karmas have their origin, continuation and finishing in vani mana kaya. Sarvasha, sarva prakari. So sarvasha means in all ways. Whatever ways we are doing karma, it ends in vani mana kaya. Either of them, you only speak, that also is karma. So it starts and gets finished in vani. Mentally you think, that also is karma. And that is starting and ending in mind. Otherwise we are actually doing by body. That starting and ending in body. So in whatever way you are doing karma, it is being done only by these three. And these three are born from Prakriti. And so Prakriti only is doing karma. Sarva prakare. Ya pashyati upalabhate. Pashyati is not always seeing, experiencing. One who experiences that my body and mind only are working, I am not working. Like that one who experiences. Tatha atmanam kshetragyam. So himself is that knower. So you have seen now this kshetragya word is used for the reflected self or for the real self. There is no difference because self is self. So kshetragya means that knower. Akartaram sarvopadi vivarjitam. So this kshetragya has no upadi. There is nothing which he assumes as his nature. So he is transcendent. He is absolutely transcendent. Pashyati. Like that one who sees, experiences, paramartha darshi iti abhipraya. That means he is the man with right knowledge, right perception. Ultimately right perception, paramartha darshi iti abhipraya. That is the meaning. Nirgunasya akartu, nirvisheshasya akashasya iva vede Pramananupapatti ityartha. And that is what Gaudapada has shown. That he is referring here. Now, Akash is there. And we feel Gadakash, Matakash, and in thousands. But Akash is not different. So you may feel my body, your body, myself, itself, self is only one. Self may appear divided and many, but self is only one, like Akasha. Iti bhede pramana anupapattihi. So in different of Atmans, there is no logic. Like Akasha is always undivided, though it may appear like divided, vinashyatsu avinashyanta. So it is never divided. So there is no logic to say that beings are different. Pramana anupapattihi. No means of knowledge can show you that we are separate. Now, what I feel as the most important declaration of the Gita about the real Atmajnana has come now. The most important declaration of what is a man of knowledge. Most important. Throughout the Gita, one shloka will kill all other arguments. Those who harp upon Atman is only transcendent, this is a reply, slap in their face. Yada bhuta prithak bhavam ekatvam anupashyati tata eva cha vistara brahma sampaddate tada. Brahma sampaddate. That means he has got Brahman. He has achieved Brahman. When? Tada. Then only. When? He says, all the different, previously told that there is no upapatti for different. He experiences that all the beings, all the different beings becoming one in Nirvikalpa Samadhi only. In Nirvikalpa Samadhi he sees that all the different beings appearing have become one. Ekastam in one. All the different beings are dissolved in one. And from that one only, he sees they are expanding. Tata eva cha. From that one only, vistaram pashyati. Pashyati is repeated. He sees the vistar coming out. Then only he is a Brahmajna. As per Shankar's habit, he has the meaning also he has brought back the transcendence.
There is Anupashyati.
Anupashyati Shastra Acharya Upadesha Anu. Anupashyati is always the same meaning. That having learned from Shastras and Acharyas, he sees it. Shastra and Acharya have told him how to get Nirvikalpa Samadhi. So in that Nirvikalpa Samadhi, he sees everything has become one. And from that one only, he sees everything being one. Corroboration, Mahapurush Maharaj. Or Mandukya Upanishad description. Buddha description. Though in Buddha this coming back has not been so clearly expressed. in the first prayer of the night, Mahapurush Maharaj's individuality vanished. And he experienced he is the universal gross body. In second prayer of the night, that grossness vanished. And he experienced he is the universal subtle body. In the third prayer of the night, that unified or I am experiencing avyakta, that vanished, and he realized his real nature, that is called Turiya. And then the mind came back. That is the most important thing. Foolishly people say, mind get dissolved, how can it come back? Miracle. Hundreds of people talk like that. That is miracle, so the mind is dissolved. How can it come back? Who has told mind is dissolved? Who has told? Gaudapada says, Nishpannam Brahma Tat Tada, that very mind they see as Brahman. In Sushupti, mind may appear like for some time, not in Samadhi. So, then his mind came back. But his mind did not come back in this very route. First he was appear of Sri Ramakrishna. After Nirvikala Samadhi, first he was aware of Sri Ramakrishna. Now if he was aware of anything, that means his I had come back. Then only he can be aware of something. So in the subtlest form, the I has come back. I the experiencer, that's all. But I am experiencing Sri Ramakrishna. And then the mind further came down and he saw from that Sri Ramakrishna body, all the Deva Devatas are coming out. And then from all the Deva Devatas, we all, the entire world is coming out. And once it so happened, it started Anulom Vilom repeatedly. All of us vanished in Devadevatas, Devadevatas vanished in Sri Ramakrishna, and mind again goes to Nirvikala Samadhi. Like that several times it happened, Anulom Vilom. And then he was permanently established in the idea that Sri Ramakrishna is the Yukavatar. And or we say, Sarva Devadevi Swaru. So that was seen by him. From Sri Ramakrishna, all the Deva Devatas have come out. As a result, when he used to sit in his room, we have seen that. This is the position, na? You see the photo. Sitting slightly bent forward with folded hands. No, it is not a video, it is a photo. Otherwise, you could have heard. He goes on saying Ramakrishna, Ramakrishna, Ramakrishna. So he is aware only of Ramakrishna throughout his life. Then we are supposed going to him from outside. As we are going nearer, he sees from that Ramakrishna a Devi is coming out. Deva Devi is coming out. And then we come in front of him in his room. Then he sees that from that Deva Devi, this one has come out. That was his permanent vision. And so immediately he could say, this is your Ishta. That Deva Devi from which he had come out. Ultimately ending in Sri Ramakrishna. So, understood. So, that is called Brahmajna. That from that very one, he sees many. He sees many through intervention of Sri Ramakrishna and gods and goddesses. Then all. Tata vistar bolna na. Vistar means expansion. Gradual expansion. first in the form of Sri Ramakrishna, then Devadevata, then we are. Tada Brahma Sampadyate. Unnecessary, I remember some incidents. In Vellore, Katpadi Vellore, two names, one station name, one town name, in Tamil Nadu. A new private ashram was coming into existence. Now, perhaps it has become our center now, at that time. And they had called a public meeting. And Mahaprasanna's disciple, Chinnu Maharaj, he was the president. And I was supposed to speak on Ramakrishna. C. Subramanyam will speak on Samayakanda. And that lady, Padma Panduranga, famous lecturer, she would speak on mother. When my turn came, I said, he has written a pamphlet. What is name? Chidbhavananda Swami. That we always say, Sarvadeva Devi Sarupaya. This is the make-believe. He has written in the pamphlet. Criticizing Ramakrishna Mission for this. Nice sitting. And I described Mahapuruji's experience. This just now which I told you. And I said, it is easily assumed that Swamiyakanda had the similar experience. And so Swamiyakanda has given this mantra. And yet, looking at him, and yet some people call it make believe, like that. Then, after lectures, we were served food. I was sitting separately. He, for him, very special arrangement was there. But he asked them to call me. He made me sit near him and showed a lot of affection. That is the end. Anyway, what to do? I remember hundreds of incidents. Anyway, we are not concerned with that. But tada brahma sampadyate tata evacha vistaram yada. Now, same thing is being explained, that feeling of different bodies, and Atma is not doer. These are further explained by various shlokas. They were stated, now they are further explained by various shlokas. Anadityat nirgunatvat Paramatma ayam avyayah sharirasthopi kaunteya na karoti na lipyate. Tvat means heto panchami, reason. This Paramatma is anadi. This Paramatma is nirgun. So is avyaya, unchanging. He is anadi, he is nirgun, so he is unchanging. So let him be seen in the body, but he is neither doing nor is bound. Vaishnava say Bhagavan has some trick. He does everything but is not bound. He says he does not do and he is not bound. He appears doing, but is nirgun. He is aware, so he is not doing. And because he is not doing, so he is not bound. Who? Paramatma. If he feel body is Atma, then he is doing something. Mind is Atma, Vani is Atma, then they are doing something. But the real Atman, being anadi and nirgun, is aware. So, appearing in the body also, he does not do anything and is not bound. Kauntheya, in between, Arjuna is being addressed. Ekasya atmana sarvadayatmatvetta dosha sambandhe prapte idam uchyate. One gets the wrong idea that because he is associated with all the bodies, so he'll get the defects of the bodies. So this reply. Anadityat anade bhava anadityam. Anadityat anadityo means the quality of being anadi is anadityo. Adi means karanam. Tad yasya na asti tad anadi. There is nothing to cause Atman. There is nothing origin of Atman. There is nothing before Atman. So anadi. Yadi adimat tat svena atmana veti. Now if something is born, then he changed. If he has undergone the birth process, then he has changed. I am to anaditva because it has no cause. Niravayava iti kritva. So he is without parts. That means he is without parts. Things with parts are born. Made, composed. He is not made of parts. So, na veti. There is no change. There is no possibility of change in him. With part, then one part gone, two parts gone. Like that there will be. Parts added, but he is without parts. So no change in him. Tatha nirgunatva, also because he is beyond the three gunas. Saguno hi guna vayatvetti. Suppose you have qualities and you lose one quality, then you are gone or you are changed. I am to nirgunatva na veti iti paramatma. I am avyayo. So he does not change, so he is avyaya. Nasya vayo vidyate iti avyaya. Avyaya means one who is not spent. Vaya means spending. So one who is not spent is avyaya. Yata evam, because it is like that, ata sharirastha api shariresthu atmana upalabdhi bhavati iti sharirastha uchyate. So how it is sharirastha? We feel Atman is in the body. Or Atman is felt in the body. So it's called sharirastha. He is not limited by the body, but appears to function through the body. Tatha na karoti. Sharirastha uchyate tatha na karoti. So he does not do anything. Tad akaranat eva tad phalena nilipyate. Because he is not doing, so he is not getting the result. Doing and then not getting the result is not possible. He is not doing, so he is not getting the results. Yo hi karta sa karma phalena lipyate. I am to akarta, ato na phalena lipyate iti artha. If somebody is doer, then he will be bound by the result. But he is not the doer, so he is not bound. That is the meaning. Now, doubts. Kapuna deshu karoti lipyate cha, yadi tavad anya paramatmano dehi karoti lipyate cha, tata idam anupapanna muktam kshetrajna. Ishvara ekatvam kshetranyam chapi mamiti are purana argument repeat vara. Then who is doing in that body? If he is not doing, then who is doing in that body? If there is somebody different than Paramatman, then your things are meaningless. Kshetranya is myself, kshetranya and all that. Na karoti, na lipyate, all that becomes meaningless, illogical. Your kshetrajna, ishvara ekatva, kshetrajna chapi mahavidhi, this also becomes illogical. If somebody other than God is doing something in the body, अथ नास्ति ईश्वराद अन्यो देहि तात् करोति लिप्यते च इति वाच्यं पुरोव नास्ति इति. सो इफ देर इज नथिंग नो बॉडी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ईश्वर देन हू डज एंड गेट्स बाउंड दैट मस्ट बी टोल्ड. ईश्वर इज नॉट डूइंग नॉट डूइंग बट समबडी इज डूइंग सो हू इज दैट वन शुड टेल. पुरोव नास्ति इति or you should say there is no reality. Vah paro nasti. There is no such transcendent self that you should accept. Same argument going on. Sarvatha durvijnayam durvachyam cheti bhagavat proktam upanishadam darshanam parityaktam vaisheshikai sankhya arhata bhaktaicha. So what Bhagavan is telling is can't be understood, can't be properly told. So this Upanishad Darshan is thrown away by Vaisheshikas, Sankhyas, Jainas and Buddhas. Because both ways we don't understand. Somebody different is there, then your Atma Ekatva is gone. If somebody different is not there, either there is no Atman or Atman is the doer. Different in different bodies. So this illogical, it appears impossible to understand, impossible to describe. So this Bhagavad Darshan philosophy being told by Bhagavan and all the Upanishads also is meaningless. So it is rejected by Vaisheshikas, Sankhyas, Arhat Mijainas and Buddha. Tatra ayam pariharo bhagavata svena eva utta. Shankar says, all this has been replied by Bhagavan himself. Sva vastu pravartate iti. It is Maya which is working. Svabhav. Bhagavan has said, I do not do anything. Every man's nature, that Maya is working. That is the reply given to all your objections. Mayam tu prakriti vidya. Again, that comes. Avidya bhav, avidya matra svabhavu. Your svabhava consists of ignorance. Hi karoti. That is who is doing. Your svabhav, your mind filled with avidya is doing. Kuruti lipyate iti vyaharo bhavati. So about him we say he is doing it. He is bound by the phalas. It's all about the avidya. Avidya svabhav. Natu paramarthata ekasmin paramatmani tadasti. Natu paramarthata. Not ultimately. Because in one paramatma, nothing of this is there. No ajnan, no karma, no fal. In one paramatma. So, ultimately, nobody is doing anything. It is an appearance. Karma and karma fal. In that way, Bhagavan has already replied. Ata etasmin paramartha sankhya darshane sthitanam. Sankhya here means Vedanta. He has used sankhya in two words. First sankhya is the sankhya philosophy. And here is sankhya is Vedanta. Paramartha sankhya darshane. Ultimate sankhya darshan. That is Vedanta. Sankhya means good knowledge, real knowledge. And that Sankhya is counting knowledge. Sthitanam, those who are established in this real knowledge, Jnananishthanam, Sannyasis, Jnananishtha. That means they are firm in their knowledge. This knowledge may be yet developing, but that knowledge is steady in them. Paramahansa Parivrajakanam. They are called the Paramahansa Sannyasis. and Paramahamsa's energy are always walking, never in one place. Tiraskruta Vidya Vivaranam, and they have not accepted the avidya functions. Karmadikaro nasti. So, you bring that back, they are not fit to do any karma. Iti tatra tatra darshitam bhagavata, and this has been shown by Bhagavan himself in many places. Now that Akasha example was given by Shankaracharya. Now Bhagavan himself gives that example. Yatha sarvagatam saukshmyat akasham nopalipyate sarvatra avasthito dehe tathatma nopalipyate. We'll read these 2-3 shlokas tomorrow, ending the chapter. Om prapanna parijataya तोत्र वेत्र एकपाणये ज्ञानमुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृत दुहे नमः ओम शांति 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 हरि ओम तत्सत् श्री राम कृष्ण अर्पणमस्तु
प्रपन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्र एकपाणये ज्ञानमुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः।